In this experiment, we are going to find out the coefficient of static friction between paper and paper, paper and sandpaper, paper and smooth book wrap, paper and matte book wrap, and lastly, paper and Teflon. So the procedure is simple. First, we are going to cut out a piece of paper and wrap it around a piece of eraser. Second, the eraser is put on an inclined plane. Alright, it's me editing the video. I actually forgot to say that it was inclined plane wrapped with paper, so keep that in mind. The inclined plane is tilted slowly until the eraser begins to slide. The angle theta is recorded. Steps 2 to 3 is repeated 5 times and average reading of theta is calculated. Coefficient of static friction is then calculated using the formula below. Finally, steps 1 to 5 is repeated by replacing paper with other material. Now, if you haven't checked out my last video about friction, make sure you check it out because I explained a lot about friction in that video. I will link that in my description. Now I would like to talk about how does the formula work. First of all, I would like to introduce a formula that you probably already know if you watch my previous video. Now rearrange the formula to find the coefficient of static friction. So from here we know that the coefficient of static friction is nothing but the static friction divided by the normal force. Now let me draw the free body diagram of the inclined plane in the experiment. We know that Wx is equal to static friction because we want to calculate the coefficient of static friction, and Wx is nothing but, now we want to express the normal force in terms of theta. We know that Fn is equal to Wy because again we want to calculate the coefficient of static friction, and the normal force is nothing but. Now substitute 2 and 3 into 1. And we know that sine divided by cosine is nothing but tangent. So the coefficient of static friction is nothing but. Now there are several precautionary steps while carrying out this experiment. First of all, we must move the inclined plane as steady as possible. This is to prevent any external force from acting on the eraser. I found this hard to do, so I introduced pulleys. A pulley tracks distance for force. That means we need to move 1 cm in order for the inclined plane to raise 0.5 cm. Okay, what I mean here was I need to move a lot at the input and the output will just move a little bit. And protractor is not very accurate for this purpose. So, alright, it's me again while editing the video. So, I actually don't mean that the protractor is not accurate itself, but rather, I mean, the setup itself is fairly inaccurate. First of all, the protractor can move around like this. And another reason is that it is rather hard to find the origin of the slope. So I would rather stick with the digital protractor instead, and it will be much more accurate. And here is the result.
Oh well, I think the result for Teflon is a little bit off.
Based on the result, the coefficient of static friction between paper and sandpaper is the largest, which is 0.54. This is followed by paper and paper, which is 0.39. And the next one was Teflon, which was quite off, and smooth book wrap. Finally, matte book wrap. Thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe, like, and share. And happy physicsing.